The first way we are going to do this is by using the DirectX diagnostic tool. And to open this tool, we are going to use the run command. So click the start button and then type run in the search field. And then of course, choose run from the search results. Or another thing you can do is you can right click the start button and then choose run from the list. All right, so now once the little run window has popped up, type DXDiag in the text field. And this stands for DirectX Diagnostic Tool. And now you should see a list of general system specs. From there, click the display tab. And now you can see some basic specs about your graphics card, such as the name, manufacturer, chip type, amount of memory, and so on. And on the right side, you can also see some driver information as well. But the problem is, this information is just too basic for many of us. So to dig deeper into graphics card specs, we are going to use a little tool called GPU-Z. Many of you have probably heard about CPU-Z, but this time we are going to use GPU-Z for graphics cards. In the video description, I will include a link to download both the portable and the standard version of GPU-Z. Once you have installed and opened GPU-Z, you should now see much more specs. So now here are some specs you should focus on. The first one is technology. The smaller the number, the better, because it means more transistors can fit inside the chip. As a result, the chip can be more efficient and you can get a lot more performance out of it. And from the release date, you can already tell that this is a pretty old graphics card that clearly needs to be replaced now. For memory type or graphics card generation, it should be GDDR5 or higher, so that way your graphics card is future-proof for several years. And for memory size or the amount of memory, it should be at least 3 gigabytes. That should be enough to run most graphics decently at 1080p. Now between $200 and $300, you can find some really, really decent graphics card online. In fact, some of them have around 6 gigabytes of memory. And that's it. It's really that simple to check GPU specs on Windows 10. And now for more fun, simple, and straightforward tutorials like this, please subscribe and thanks for watching.